Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the Low Rev Podcast, where all of the racing news that has happened will be discussed. I am Wankel Rotary Engine, and with me is Ricco Suave. Ricco, what's going on?
How are you doing this evening, Wankel?
Oh, you know, hanging out with a little bit of the beverage.
That's good to hear. So, for me, the most exciting news of the week is this Mario Kart Tour information.
My goodness. They're going to have, now, the last time they tried this, the Fire Flowers really, really wreaked havoc with the crowds. Any ideas on how they're going to contain the kind of backblast or overspray from the track?
I would assume they're just going to use nets, but I don't know how effective nets are at fire.
Not the best, but at least they're trying something. So safety first, kids.
They could wet the net.
They could indeed, or maybe they could give the crowd some super soakers, possibly. A little sponsorship.
I'm into this idea.
Excellent. Make sure you stay safe out there, kids. I mean, one more reason to just wear the mask. You don't need the fumes or the any kind of fire getting actually in your lungs at that point.
I do, however, enjoy the smell of fire.
Indeed, very much so. There, I believe it was the warrior poet Gandhi who once said, "Love the smell of napalm in the morning."
He was a big war guy.
Indeed. Didn't eat a lot, but enjoyed killing. What's next up on the agenda for the news stories we have going on here?
Well, let's take a look here. I'm seeing there's information that Tony Stewart is planning on starting a new racing league to give an alternative to NASCAR.
Now, is this a direct response to the banning of the Confederate flag and trying to remove the stigma of racism from NASCAR? Is this going to be a pro-racism racing league, the racisming league, if you will?
I believe it will be fully racist.
Interesting. So very inclusive, yet not so much.
Correct. There's talk of Confederate flags and other racist emblems shall be plastered on all cars entered.
Interesting. Will you, in fact, have to have a kind of a cross wire to your aerial and then set it on fire as you race?
Everything seems to be about fire this week.
Seems to be that way. It is summer, so, you know, it did get up to 26 degrees here in actual measurement. I'm not sure what that is in foolish height, but it's probably about about 110. I could look it up. I'm going to look it up.
110 is on the warm side over here. Today was about 97 degrees, and boy, it was hot.
That does sound a lot hotter than it was here, because I just looked it up, and 26 degrees Celsius is just about 79 degrees Fahrenheit. So, again,
that's a comfortable day, Wankel.
That sounds like possibly your manifold would be frothing over, but that's just me, and I live much further north, where cooling isn't usually an issue the majority of the year. Shout out to my homeboy, the Yeti.
Oh. Sup, Yeti?
Indeed. If I kind of hooked him up with that whole Jax Links sponsorship deal. No big deal.
That was nice. Very, very nice of you.
Well, I mean, he was kind of down on his luck and didn't really have much going on, just kind of living out with the trees and such. And I was like, you like meat? He's like, yeah, well, they make this meat that lasts for a while and it's really chewy. He's like, well, that sounds better than the raw stuff I'm used to. And they liked the way he looked and the sheen of his hair. There was some talk with L'Oreal for a while, but apparently they're a bit sexist.
They may enjoy that new racing league.
Hey, new sponsorship deal, possibly. Maybe we can get some long-haired fellows hanging their head out the side of the car, flapping their L'Oreal hair in the breeze.
I think I may be interested in this now.
I'm being more and more intrigued myself.
There's nothing like long-haired gentlemen to just take your Sunday up a notch, you know?
Imagine becoming the Fabio of racing.
Good one, Wank.
Ha, ha, ha.
So, in other racing news, I've heard that Kyle Busch won and then didn't win.
That seems to be contradictory at best.
Yes. I was curious to find out what happened, but then I took a nap.
That seems likely when it comes to things like NASCAR. It seems to be a natural reaction.
Well, we could talk about maybe some F1 news.
They do tend to go a lot faster and turn left and right.
Yes. Yes, they turn in both directions multiple times per race.
Kinky.
Do you happen to have any F1 news?
Well, I believe the great Pablo Montoya has not raced in some time.
I wonder if he's the only one.
Well, there's possibly others. But wouldn't know who they are.
I wonder if he's maybe under the weather?
Very possibly. Quite far under.
Oh, here's some interesting information. Castro Neves is calling for a BOP. Do you know what that stands for, Wank?
I believe that's beer on point.
That is exactly correct. He's looking for some BOP on an Acura.
Well, that doesn't make any sense at all. You'd get pulled over immediately for open containers in the car.
These race car drivers are wild guys.
Is it true that they put straight grain alcohol in their drinking tanks?
What else could a car run on?
That is very true. Well, maybe they just run the drinking straw right into the gas tank. That way you fuel both things.
You think we could modify that in our vehicles?
That, I think, would be ideal. For the simulated racing crowd, make sure you get yourself a nice Camelback and fill it with your finest of grain alcohols.
You know, I am almost certain that one Meodred is drinking grain alcohol while racing. I've seen some questionable decision-making, shall we say, from that driver.
Well, I believe the grain alcohol does have a certain effect, but I believe it may have more to do with the Colombian marching powder and a tendency to shout obscenities rather than actually look in his mirrors.
Marching powder.
Indeed.
That sounds intriguing.
It is rather invigorating, I am led to believe.
Oh, it's an uplifting powder, you say?
Very much so. It does help things get done quickly. Maybe not accurately, but quickly.
And that's what racing is all about.
Heck yeah.
Oh, did you hear? There's big news in the racing world. One Richard Petty has retired.
Whoa, that would be, I believe, a spoiler alert.
Yes, we should probably have warned people before I shared that information. I apologize.
Make sure you sound off the sirens. Do 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 do.
Do 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 do.
It says here in the world of two-legged racing that Mr. Divozioso has warned Ducati that they have to make a step despite podium. I don't know what to tell this gentleman, but all podiums are stepped like that.
Classic wank. Oh, I've seen in the supercar series that three teams were fined for walking the track.
Well, I mean, that's clearly unsafe. Should be in a car with a roll cage. Isn't that, I don't know a lot about safety. I choose to disregard a lot of it myself, but I'm fairly certain you shouldn't be walking on the track.
That can't be the fastest way around the track, no?
Maybe. What if they had Usain Bolt on their team?
He is a fast walker.
Indeed.
He may be the fastest walker.
I don't know. That would be an interesting thing to figure out. Is he able to walk faster than the average human being? Or is it just the running thing?
Well, he is a tall gentleman, I believe, in the 7-foot range. That probably lengthens his leg stride.
Yeah, that is very true. The one thing I might point out is, in terms of speed walking, there is a fair amount of technique, as I understand. You basically have to look like you're having an aneurysm all the time and work your hips as though you're listening to Elvis nonstop.
Yes, the hip swivel is of most important technique.
I found it to be so in my general daily life.
You swivel your hips often, Wang?
Well, you see, it's easier to get around, draws a certain amount of attention, that kind of thing.
I bet you get plenty of attention.
This is very true, and not only because of the hips.
Hmm.
Are there any other interesting things happening in the world of racing this week there, Ricardo?
Well, it looks like BTCC has reverted to full 10-round schedule for the upcoming season.
Well, that's at least 2 rounds shy of the regular WBO fights that I'm used to watching. I wonder why they're going with 10 rounds instead of only 12.
I do not know. There must be a reason.
I'm sure there is, but it's probably chalked up to cowardice.
Sissies.
12 rounds or GTFO in your GTO, if you will.
I see that Aprilia has gotten completely lost.
No GPS?
And apparently not. They're lost.
Well, we will send out our thoughts and prayers to the search teams looking for these fine people.
Yeah, stay safe, guys.
Perhaps next time, bring a flare and a map.
Or a buddy.
Hey.
You never want to be lost alone.
Two heads are better than one, and then you can play poker.
What else do we have on the news for this week, Wank?
Well, apparently there are anomalies causing the 2020 F1 car of Red Bull to misbehave, Perhaps it's all the caffeine.
How would you handle a misbehaving vehicle?
Well, generally, if a stern talking to doesn't get the job done, then you just have to take it out behind the garage and drain all the oil.
That sounds reasonably fair.
Generally gets the job done. Well, I think that's all we have for you this week on the Low Rev Podcast. I, Wankel Rotary Engine, wish you the best, and from Rico Suave as well, enjoy yourselves, or don't.